Well, aloha folks, and welcome back to the Theodericing Dynasty. Oh my god, it's episode 5 and I still can't pronounce it. Last episode was more exciting than I could have hoped for. We're still alive, our dynasty is still alive, but we only have a few provinces in Saxony proper. We have Hamburg, that is our personal holding. We have a family member who holds Lüneburg, and I believe another family member who holds Nassau. And the difficulty has gone from super easy to basically hard, which isn't a problem. We will survive, don't worry. But if we look at the religious map mode, we can see that Central Europe is in chaos, right? After Charlemagne failed and his brother failed to, you know, stand up against us, the Sunnis have been making progress, and the Tengri are still around. The Slavic peoples have not been subjugated. They have really pounded us quite a bit. And what else? Look, the Pictish are still Picts. Oh, wait, no, what is this? Oh my god, a Khanate. Wow. I would never have thought that. That is pretty incredible. Now, what is our strategy going to be? Our strategy is, of course, going to be to reproduce and spread wide. Obviously, we probably want to reclaim the Saxon crown, but I think it's better even if we go ahead and try to move east as I planned before, because that would be pretty cool after all. The Duke of Holstein basically wants to take a hostage. Commander. I can't do that. I like how we're actually a Christian chiefdom. Does that mean... Alright, we haven't actually become a thing, right? Ah, there we go. Renounce secret faith. Now, this guy is 68, so he's gonna die soon, and he's homosexual, so seduction focus doesn't really work for us in that regard. But we will... Temple Vassal, Opinion Marshal, I don't know. Yeah, let's go for business. The Pope has sympathy for Islam, and he's a wicked priest with wrath and pride and a dutiful cleric. That's very interesting. The possible successor is zealous with gout. Yeah, he's not gonna... He's possessed as well. Damn. Oh, my vassal's Norse here, and he won't convert, so let's get rid of him. Success! That only took a few days. Impressive. Holy shit, this guy's dumb. Imbecile. 0000000. Oh my god. I mean, I almost feel like removing him as well, just because I want some smarter people in my court. This guy's 32. He's a little bit better. I think that's okay. My last heir passed away, I think. Nope. They've just voted for someone else. Theodoric Ludolfsson. And a new heir, another Theodoric Ludolfsson. Wait, did you? Is it? No, it can't be the same person. This person's a lot smarter. This probably won't work, but I think I'm gonna vote for an imbecile as the heir. Or at least a slow person. Ugly, yeah, slow person. There. Liaviso. Chancellor, fine. Commander, okay. Ooh. The Prince of Bavaria. Sounds good. Sounds good to me. If I'm gonna be completely honest, I thought I would already have an empire by now. But then again, I'm too used to playing in Scandinavia. Scandinavia might just be a little bit OP. And another matrilineal marriage in Bavaria, which means that, of course, they have elective. So it's probably not gonna happen, but we'll have people with claims at least. Reynold, Prince of France, matrilineal marriage. I mean, yes, go. Ugh, I just realized my court chaplain is Norse. What? How dumb I am. Jesus. Time to remove my wife. I also noticed she's also Norse and she's old, so no more children. I need children. Children are good. Magnus. Now that's a good name. Ooh. Oh, twins. Katharina. Also good. Kaboom! I wonder, is this the same... Yeah, it's the same priest. He's called for a crusade against, no, it's just that crusades can begin. But it's kind of funny that it's by a wicked priest with sympathy for Islam. The Teutonic Order, ooh. St. Mary, and where are they? Hofmeister. Oh, somewhere here. Good. Knights of St. John, etc. The Knights of Calatrava, Santiago. Perfect. And a few days later, he passes away, which is quite fitting, in my opinion. Let's see, okay, whatever. Chief Ludolf has given up the ghost of age 74. He died a natural death, known to be kind. Few had bad words to say about him. A godly man, Ludolf is with Jesus now. Chief Theodoric, a reclusive man, he is perfectly fine letting the council do most of his work, for better or for worse. Long live Chief Theodoric. Time to get all seductive in here and spread the dynasty. It's funny how it still says that I can take concubines, even though we've actually just inherited the kingdom again. Like, I understood that it could be a bug before, but this time it's sort of odd. Seduce the 50-year-old ruler. Actually, are there any younger ones? Aquitaine, maybe? Crimea. Interesting. Ooh, this is a powerful duchess. This is interesting. My heir and son with the Princess of Italy. Perfect. Now, there's one question, though. Ooh, actually, wow. She's the heir, so if this woman disappeared afterwards, ooh, this would be nice. Something I just noticed, Bohemia has actually turned Catholic, and they've actually incorporated this part here. Because it's this guy who actually holds the king. Oh, what? They were Catholic and now... Okay, maybe this part is Catholic, but the king is actually still Slavic. Okay, let's give up on Tomasi, but I've seen here Treviso. Treviso has a female ruler, matrilineally married, and she has only... Okay, one son, fine, whatever. It's just that she's a little bit closer, so it'd be nice... There we go, seduce. Ayla has a claim on Saxony, and he has a host. He's losing the war, but I didn't realize that he's actually of our dynasty, so I should have actually been helping him somehow. Not that we can do much, but, you know. I just didn't notice that. Theodrada. Okay. I could actually declare a war on the Kingdom of France. It would be interesting, but... Obviously, there's just no way I can win. Actually, I just realized, I just made an alliance with Italy and Bavaria. But the problem is that even if I attacked, it's an elective monarchy. So even if we did put Reynold in power, you know, there's no way to tell if the children would come to power. And he's the heir anyway, so it would be easier to just try to get rid of Rainbow here. The East is always trying to rise up. I actually feel bad. It's the 10th Saxon Revolt League. That's just... Ugh. Finally, an informal event. Meet in my room, my lady. She's 32. Will she get pregnant? That is the question. Let our love grow. Yeah, let's do that. My cousin Vidikin keeps asking me to press his claims on Zamacha for the glory of our dynasty. Wherever that is, must be super far east. Ah, over here. Declares war. I can't. Ooh, I don't think I've seen this event before. It's historically accurate, as in it's happened, but let's see. You have received strange news from Rome. The former Pope, Pope Hadrianus, did by his actions and lifestyle so defile the Holy See that the current authorities in Rome decided to put his corpse on trial. The corpse of Hadrianus was removed from its tomb and brought back to the papal court for judgment. It was propped up on a throne, and a deacon was chosen to speak for it as a legal representative. Perhaps most, or unsurprisingly, the accused was found guilty on all accounts and subjected to a punishment most dire. The corpse was stripped of its papal vestments, three fingers on the right hand were cut off, and then it was interred in a graveyard normally reserved for foreigners of low status. The punishment still not being deemed severe enough, the corpse was then exhumed again, tied to weights, and cast into the river Tiber. I'm sure the judges have acted wisely. Ugh, thinks the child is his. Damn it. No, that's not what I want. I want... Ugh, stupid shit. Let's seduce the Queen of Italy instead. My son wants to join the Knights of Caltavra. He's the Marshal and Heir. You know what? I'll allow you. Ooh, if I choose the Duke of Alemania as my heir, then we could unite our holdings. I think that's probably a good idea. And he does have quite a lot of stuff. Wow. Ooh, I think I'm sick. Let's see if there are any epidemics around. No, just in France. Very well. Food poisoning. Okay, I think I'll be okay. Bavarian revolt, yada yada yada. Of course I'll accept. Will I join? Probably not. Ooh, we have a new ruler of Holstein. I think they lost the rebellion war there. And of course, I will become marshal. You know what? Let's join the Benedictine order. I've totally forgotten about doing these things. Two gold. Okay, damn it. Friendship. Okay. Excuse me. Did we just lose a lot of territory? Something happened here. I'm not sure what. Crusade for Aquitaine. Deus Vult. Actually, yes. Should we join? I wonder. You know what? Let's do it. Let's do it. Your king, Toba, has decided to rescind the decree calling for the expulsion of all Jews. Wonderful. That means we can borrow money from the Jews and build our castle, finally. It's been kind of annoying not to be feudal. So we go here, we click borrow, and we have to pay back 350. Okay, that's fine. It's fine. They'll probably hate us, but it's fine. Okay, where is it? Reinforced Hillfort. I think this holy war is actually going pretty well. We're gathering up some money. I don't know if it's enough to pay off in time, but at least we do have money. Oh, we can go on a pilgrimage, but we need to be at peace. And also to adopt feudalism, we need to be at peace. So after this is done, we'll be fine. Again, the aim isn't actually to win this personally. I just want to expand the buffer. Or I don't know. I mean, the Pope has 6%. This guy had... Oh, 30. Oh, okay. Some people have a lot more. There's actually no way we could personally take everything unless we actually captured the Badshah. I was gonna say Caliph, but he's not a Caliph. This guy's the Caliph. Ah, shit. Oh, crap. This guy captured Hamburg, and he's making people vanish. Which is not good, because this is the basis of my entire plan here. Oh, Egbert is gonna try to become King of Bavaria. Perfect. More wars. I hate this. It's not against me, though, but Bavaria there. And also, the Crusade all of a sudden turned around. Looks like Crusaders are pretty terrible, as usual, at coordinating their attacks, which really bothers me. I mean, we have the numbers, but they just really suck at thinking things through. Go train some troops. My liege is trying to revoke the Chiefdom of Hamburg. Well, I'm gonna force you to stop. My wife is gone. Ooh, what a surprise. Right, I get a new wife and then she dies pretty much immediately. The Catholic Crusade has ended. A black day. Damn. I wonder. Still 100% though. Good. Oh, the King of Bohemia is actually a Sunni. That's unexpected. Alright, I should really be studying. I have lunch to eat and a meeting to go to. Like, I have so much shit to do. I don't know why I'm doing this. I like Crusader Kings so much. This is the problem. Paradox, stop releasing games is what I tell you. That's your priority. The problem is, even if they stopped releasing games, I'd still play this. So, yeah. Problematic. Anyway, I'll be right back. Boom! I'm back. Well, it doesn't really matter for you. I don't actually know why I excuse myself sometimes, but, at least you know that I'm a busy person, right? Bavarian Holy War for Bohemia has ended. White peace. And, the Danes are invading Holstein. Ugh, I hate this. I hate this game sometimes. You're having a revolt against this guy, who is not in my takeover plans, because your two daughters are betrothed to me. I'd rather not see you lose, but you have a pretty big revolt in your hand. I'm gonna get rid of the revolter, though. I bribed his spy master, so we have very good plot power here. Boom! My plan comes to fruition. Let's see. Of course, I have some bigger plans, but we have passed away. And so Chief Theodoric has given up the ghost at age 62. He died of poor physique, although not especially blessed. We hope Theodoric will find peace in the afterlife. Duke Hildebord, a renowned man, dignitaries from far and wide will surely bow before him. Long live Duke Hildebold. So be it. So here's the thing. Oh my god. I'll deal with this later. So yeah, we're now the Duke Hildebold of Alemannia in southern Germany here. We own Ulm, so I think. No? No, we don't. That's unfortunate. But, at least, yeah, we own some stuff, so that's nice. Wonderful. I wonder. We have lots of bastard children. Wilhelm and Magnus, okay. Interesting. And being feudal, we can finally upgrade this place to a castle, which makes it easier to control. Actually, we own quite a lot of stuff. We have these two, and then we have mines as well. So a little bit more than I expected. I'm gonna give my Wilhelm control over Hamburg here. I wonder if we could actually get a revolt going. Duke Hildebold for Germany. How old am I? 36. Maybe not such a bad idea. Oh my god. The former King of Bavaria has passed away. Damn. Shit. And his son has inherited. He has a daughter. But after that, I think, Oh, it's Hermetic. Interesting. Hermetic society, here we go. Hopefully I won't be eaten up this time. Raid this guy's laboratory. You know what? I'll have to decline. It's a little bit too risky. I don't want to get eaten alive again. That was a bit too much. Oh my god, what happened here? Saxony is under the Empire or Khanate of Tarjan. Wow. Oh, the king thinks I'm dumb. He's trying to teach, to become the teacher of my son. And yeah, he's a pretty decent guy, but you know, I'm trying to claim his throne. You know what? I think it's time to go for, because it's Ignited Gavelkind, but I think seniority is better. I like elected monarchy, but seniority at least keeps it in the family, if you know what I mean. Everyone endorsed my paper, apparently, so that's pretty cool. Now, form alliance. Wait, what war are you in? Yeah, let's offer an alliance. Ooh, an expedition to find some writings. Sounds interesting. A surviving chamber of the Great Library in Alexandria? 200 gold. 1,000 esoteric knowledge. Wait. 1,000. I mean, that's a lot of knowledge. 100. Huh. If you heard that sound, that was Windows doing something crazy. It always does crazy stuff. Look, oh, I can go to mine. Okay, so it's less expensive, but 200 gold. I don't know. Robin mines. Ah, damn it. I mean, it's expensive. But it's fun. I mean, 42%, 61%. 78%. You know what? Let's do. This is a little bit too much money for too little. We don't know if we're going to succeed here. Here we're almost certain. Ooh, we found a hidden chamber. Perfect. I wonder, can I upgrade my status? No, we need 750. Ooh, a savvy businesswoman with 20 stewardship. Come on in. Ah, an excellent painting. Let's see. No, did we get it? Oh, it's probably in the shop soon. Ah, you're blackmailing me because I'm a drunkard. I see. Well, you know what? Let's change this to be seductive. Request a claim on this title. We already have a little claim, but it's a weak one. If he dies, it's still... It's a gnatic, so a male will inherit. And I think it's just better if we spend 100 piety. Oh wait, of course. I should have checked this before. Perform scrying. Basically, I can foretell the future. I'm gonna try that. They're just lines, or are they? Yes, I see a forest, a vast forest. Clearly a bad omen. Ooh, Askrid star sign. Didn't know that was... Oh, yes, alright, okay. Let's, allow our love to grow, maybe? Alright, so I could declare war on the Byzantine Empire right now. Oh wait, Germany. No, I had a claim on, goddamn, the Byzantine Empire, I swear. Valdemar was gonna be great. We have this family member called Valdemar who had a claim on the Byzantine Empire and it was weak, and then I just made sure to ally Austrasia here, and then suddenly the claim was gone. Here it is. Oh my god, it's amazing. Just look at that. Ugh. This might be a really bad idea, but since there's already a revolt going on against the German king, I mean, at worst, we lose 200 prestige and we're imprisoned. Yeah, why not? Let's take some risk in life. There we go. Now we have our allies on our side. And this should be a pretty straightforward victory, hopefully. Fuck. Oh my god, I hate this game. I hate it so much. And my alliance has broken down. What the hell? Okay, god damn it. I just wasted money. But it was so close. So close. Oh, hey, I can press a claim on the Kingdom of Aquitaine. Or Aquitaine, yes. We'll do that instead. Screw it. Summoning the Divine. We've had this before, but let's make them tell us of the operation of the stars. Wait, what? Did I maybe I planned this. I forget, but matrilineal betrothal with the King of Saxony. Wow. I just hope she survives. Ah, yes, the Countess of Genoa has had a bastard son. Gnatic Galvokine legitimize him, which makes him... No? Is he at least on the list? Ah, there we go. Wonderful. Oh, my cat has passed away. Unfortunately, the gold is very important to me right now, so I'm not gonna, you know, have a super funeral, but we'll inter it in the garden. Oh, someone in our family is claiming the Kingdom of France. Good luck with that. I hope you succeed, actually. You have quite a lot of money. The best to you. A white piece. No. And also, I didn't notice that I lost my battle there. Quite a shame. Oh my god, okay, fine, whatever. We're out of money. Damn it. The Count of Genoa has asked if I'm having an affair with his wife, who had a child that is legitimately my son, right? I've legitimized him. And I'm just gonna deny it, because that's stupid. But I could, bruh. Let's just deny it. Oh my god, the Duke of Franconia, I totally missed that. He's, at war with me for... Ah, oh, damn it, for mines. Tarjan has conquered the Kingdom of Burgundy as well. Or at least, they've offered their vassalization, I imagine.
Very impressive, I must say.
Oh, Vilbert! You're declaring war on Aquitaine on your own. Well, good luck with that, is what I say. I wonder, what happened to the French Revolt? He lost, of course. A new realm. Emperor Gabriel of Osnabrück has decided to abandon nomadic life and settle down. So Trajan has become the titular empire of Osnabrück. I'm really bad at German. He's still Tengri, though. This is gonna be interesting. I doubt... Ooh, it's already converted. Impressive. A peace offer. Wonderful. We defeated Franconia. Oof. With that, however, I think we're gonna put a stop to this episode. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and hopefully my outro will now actually work as intended. This has been Game Gabster. Farewell.